And welcome back to Let's Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery, now beginning part 3, The Seven Serpents. I am the RPG Chick, and we're continuing our series of interactive Let's Plays, where at the end of this video, you get to choose what I do next. What decision I make will carry forward into the video following. New episodes every Monday. Deadline for voting is the Saturday after the episode comes out at midnight. So I often record these on Sunday, so I want either the Sunday or the Monday, at least most of the Monday, free to record and do, you know, render, upload, all that fun stuff. So yeah, hope to see what you guys have to say at the end of this video. We are importing our save from Sorcery 2. Now there's a cloud spell name, but I wonder if we can... Nope. No local save data. Maybe I'm not set to record or save locally. But anyway, I have the cloud thing, which will hopefully work. And I don't know if I should be, like, taking this stuff out. I'm gonna take it out. I'm just looking for the... where I wrote the friggin' spell. Cloud save. Because I don't know if other people can access your cloud save or if it checks for that. So yeah, I'll be taking this part out anyway. Oh, it's pretty cool the way it comes up. Not working. Telling me nothing... nothing saved. And let me try this again. It's not picking it up. What the hell? Okay. I am experiencing technical difficulties. I'll be right back. Okay, I went back into Sorcery 2 and saved again. I guess I can't save locally. Strange. So it gave me a different code, so I'm gonna try that one. Okay, I guess I'll show it. What the hell. It said it found one saved adventure. Okay, so you saved Kari from the Marsh Goblins, became a follower of Korga, and heard the riddle of the Sleepless Ram. The riddle of the Sleepless Ram. It sounds vaguely familiar. So yeah, oh, we can view our items from here. 6 magical, 1 treasure, 2 keys, and 2 weapons. Okay. We have a pretty... good amount of stuff right now. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to where this takes us, and let's continue the adventure. Night falls on this, the 8th day of your journey from Annaland. To the east, mighty mountains claw at the stars. You stand on the edge of Badubak, a wild and desolate place. Beyond lies Mampang Fortress, the Archmage, and the Crown of Kings. The path has been long. Yes, and winding and backtracking. Leaving the hills, you journeyed into Kare and saved it from destruction by goblins. You lost your spirit guide on its streets, becoming a follower of Korga, the god of grace. You were captured by slavers, and you overcame the deadly portal traps of the city, ancient, cruel magic designed to trap the unwary. The backlands are different. But the plains of Badubak will be different. Once, long ago, this land thrived, prospering in the warm shadow of the Fortress of Sorcerers, high in the Zanzunu peaks. Then something changed. They say the last refugee to reach Kare declared only they are all gone. The North Gate was sealed, and the backlands left to die. Now the gates stand open. They say the land beyond the gates is cursed. No one from the young country of Annaland has ever crossed this wilderness before. You will be the first. The old world is counting on you. But already you have no food and little gold. This stage of your journey will be punishing, but you cannot turn back. I don't go back in that city. Inkle presents. Not the Forest of Snatta. No. Steve Jackson's Sorcery. Part 3. The Seven Serpents. Wonder how long or short this one's gonna be. The first episode, or part 1, turned out to be like 5 hours or something. And the second one was, I forget how much, but it was more than twice as long. The stones of the old road disappear under a layer of dust and sand. At your back looms the great wall of the city port of Kare. Ahead, there is nothing but an empty waste and the night. Look back. You cast a last glance at the city port. Even now, Vic is taking control. The baying of his wolves echoes across the plains. I guess if you're going to choose between goblins and werewolves, which is worse? Now, I could look at this two ways. This could either be naive or cautious, or this could be, what do you call it, optimistic or pessimistic. Or one time we looked up at the stars and found out a new spell. Yeah, let's look at the stars. You turn your gaze from Kari to the stars, wondering what fresh secrets they may hold this far from the halls, or walls rather, of Annaland. Alright, so let's take a look at the map here. Wow, we've got all this uncharted stuff. And then over here, the Baduban Ridge. The Forest of Snatta. What's with this stuff? Is this... Oh, it went away. And now it's coming back. Does this mean it's foggy, like we haven't been there? Or is this, like, kind of poisonous gas? It looked like another letter was visible there for a second. The Kladaban Steps, the Horns of Inklala, Lower Zaman, Karabak River, Lake Ilklala. Yeah. Tin Pang River. I could say that one. Alright, so. And there's little old me. Draw a path to the flag. Every step along the broken road takes you further from safety and into the unknown. Something, Korga perhaps, sets your senses tingling. You are not alone out here. Is that the screech of a bird you hear, or a distant scream? Should I cast a spell or draw my sword? Will that give me an edge over something? I'm not going to cast a spell. I wonder if drawing my sword will give me an initiative edge against... I don't even know. You always go first in these battles, so... I'll draw my sword, I guess. Trusting to your instincts, you draw your Annaland sword. I was distracted, sorry, by this picture. At your back, you hear the rush of wings and the call of a gigantic bird. A moment later, a ferocious nighthawk has plunged from the sky, talons outstretched for your neck. Roll aside, duck, or slash at the bird. I'm looking to end the video here, so I'm going to make my own choice. Roll aside. I lost something. I think I lost 2 points. You try to roll aside, but you are too slow. Sharp talons rake down your back. Pretty cool looking bird, huh? The bird wheels up into the sky to rejoin its group. You count 4 birds circling, ready to attack. I don't think running is going to do any good. I don't think shouting at them is going to do much either. Let's cast a spell. Fireball! I know how to do this. I don't remember that little tooltip showing up. Oh, I can't cast Fireball. I am limited, of course. So fog is a darkness spell. Let me just look what else we have. Well, we have a lot to choose from. W-A-L is the wall, the visible wall. Oh, there's two different Fs? That's a lowercase f. Oh, I didn't know that. F-A... I didn't realize there were two different out. Fall is feather fall? I'm not in the air. I guess if one of them picks me up, that would be helpful. I'm not going to look at all of them because I have a... There's a lot to choose from. Hold animate or inanimate object. I need a staff of oak sapling. Oh, I think I have that actually. Hold, like hold monster. That would take care of one of them. This is animal control or stupid person, I believe. Both. Don't I need something for that? I hear people laughing. Why should I be hearing people laughing? We're not in the city. I'm used to hearing people in the city. Charm animal. Yeah, we don't need anything for that. Let's charm animal. Three stamina. The birds are screaming down out of the sky just as you complete your spell. Then suddenly, they freeze in midair and begin to beat their wings in a terrible confusion. You have control of their will, but what use will you turn it to? Oh, kind of tempted. I don't think they can carry me, though. I mean, that would be skipping all this land, all these adventures. I don't want to... Yeah, I don't want to, like... I don't want to do that. Fly away to attack or attack each other. If I have them attack each other, that's kind of what I want to do. Am I going to lose the grace of Korga? I hope not. I mean, they're animals. One of them to attack each other. Mercilessly, you instruct the birds to turn on each other, and in moments they are lost in a scrambled mass of feathers and claws and screaming beaks. You stand back and watch as the group plunges to the dust, still fighting and scrambling. Then, quite suddenly, the Nighthawks break formation. Something else is shimmering into visibility in their very midst. Would we have a dragon? What would make them... Do I want to move uphill? I don't have an option to hide. Run forward. If I stand up here, that's going to make me a better target for whatever's coming, right? You turn and start running along the old road. Your heart pounds in your chest. Wings beat behind you. Whatever has frightened the Nighthawks away is coming after you. Huh. Drop, roll, and stab. Do that. Mastering your fear, you realize that though you cannot outrun a bird, you may be able to leverage surprise. Without slowing your pace, you pitch forward, throwing your weight into a roll that brings your sword up in place to skewer the swooping creature. Stab! You stab, but a talon the size of an orc knocks the blade easily aside. Behind it, a shadowy form materializes, and you gasp. This is no monster, but a gold-crest eagle from the king's own eyrie in Annaland. Okay, this is me thinking, I guess. The eyrie is deep behind the Shemutanti wall. Or am I telling it that? Threaten it? This is the king's... This is the king's bird. A or C? Stand back to see what it does. The The eerie is deep behind the Shamutanti wall. It must have flown for 3 days to reach you. But why? The creature, slowly becoming visible, sees you have recognized it. It folds its wings and settles to the ground before you, beak tilted low. Look at the creature. The creature stands taller than a tavern, and its wingspan is enough to sweep 9 riders from their horses when it dives. The eagles have long been powerful allies of Annalan because of their great power, but also their stealth. By tilting their feathers sideways, the creature can deflect light around its body, becoming almost invisible against the open sky. Huh, that's pretty awesome. Bow? Still catching your breath, you bow your head to the eagle. It opens its beak in reply, and something falls to the ground. It is a message cylinder. Whatever it contains must be of vital importance, or the king would not have risked revealing your location like this to deliver it. What is this? You ask. The bird looks at you impassively. Of course, it can understand you, but it cannot speak. Of course, we're going to take the tube. Oh, nice. We have gold again. You reach down and pick up the tube. Inside are 10 gold pieces and a rolled parchment, sealed with the royal seal of the King of Annaland. Okay. Let me squint here. As far as I know, I cannot make these bigger. We trust these tidings reach you in fair health, but must warn you of the impending peril. Your mission is discovered. The Mampeng's eyes have spied our plan, and word is on its way to the Dark Fortress. Too late we discovered our unwelcome eavesdroppers, and news of your quest is being carried towards High Zaman by 7 Serpents, the Archmage's most trusted servants. By now they will have reached the backlands, and here they will divide to complete their journey separately. Sorry, it's a little hard to read. If you are still able, seek them out, for they must stop to rest and eat. Destroy the creatures before they reach their goal, else the Archmage will prepare a deadly welcome for you. Find Shadrach the Hermit for advice, for naught moves through the backlands. You spelled backlands wrong, without his knowledge. Our hearts are with you. And there's the royal seal of the King of Annaland. Bloop. Thank the eagle. You can't answer me, so I didn't pick the other one. You look up, but the gold-crested eagle has already rendered itself invisible once more. You feel the rush of air as its great wings lift it from the ground. Then you are alone. Huh. Should I destroy the message? The reason to destroy the message is in case I'm captured or something. Or searched. Well, we have to destroy them before they get to the Archmage. I'm going to destroy the message. I mean, I'm assuming my character in the game can remember it. I mean, we definitely will. This is being recorded for posterity, after all. You tear the note into shreds and toss them to the wind. You will not quickly forget what it said. It would seem the backlands are not as deserted as you had supposed. You must find these 7 serpents and destroy them, or your journey will be for nothing. You have found 2 new clues, and another clue has been updated. Yay! No decision is permanent. Rewind, yes, etc. Let's check our clues. Quick, to the clues section! 7 serpents threaten your journey, for they carry a message that will warn the Archmage of your coming. Shadrach the Hermit can help you. The use of silver weapons can harm the undead. Right, we knew that before. The sleepless ram You are given a clue about the Backlands. For sleeping of the sleepless ram, seek the one they call the Sham. The Sham. We still have this Kare gate key. And the copper key, I have no idea what that's for anymore. Magic items. That's, yeah. It's funny, some of this stuff is like, they got rid of some of the clues, and well, they got rid of all the clues, but we still have some of the keys and the items from the old part. And here's our spell book, of course. We have this silver chain now we can use to fight, I guess. We fought with it once. And we have the badge of the Seventh Noble. Along the road. The stars turn in the sky overhead. Taking the pole as your guide, you make your way north along the blasted road. Before you, the Backlands stretch away to a dim horizon. How can you hope to locate Seven Serpents in such a wilderness? I must find Shadrach, the hermit. No doubt this Shadrach will help you. Though, how does the King of Annalan know who lives in the Backlands? Is there more to this wilderness than you know, or is the king relying on the unreliable foresight of his farseers? I have no idea. At the cliff. After about half an hour, you see a deep black line across the earth up ahead, and catch your step just in time. You are one pace away from the edge of a sheer cliff. A few loose stones disappear over the edge and clatter away into the dark. Look for a way down. I could always cast Featherfall and just float down. You pace along the line of the cliff in both directions, looking for a path down, but can make out nothing. Perhaps if you go closer, you'll be able to feel your way, or perhaps you would do better to camp here and wait for daylight. You sense powerful stars in the skies above. Peer over the edge. So the end. So the last line. You stride to the cliff edge and lean out. The drop is considerable. The bottom of the cliff is lost in darkness. But after a moment, your eyes pick out a series of regular, carved edges in the face of the cliff. A freak of geology? Or a staircase. It is impossible to be certain. From across the plain you hear the distant sound of flapping wings. More Nighthawks? I guess they mean from across the plain behind me? Look back? You look back across the dark plains and you see flashing claws and talons rippling against the stars. Then something happens. The birds are screaming, wheeling, breaking formation. A figure moves in the darkness beneath. Huh. Is it myself? Look at the figure. You try to make out more through the darkness, but though you recognize the figure, you cannot place her. It is female, like me, so watch further. What follows is a rage of feathers, of birds locked in combat. But suddenly the whole scene is gone. The plains and skies are empty once more. I was seeing the past or something. There is something very strange about this place. The wind skims over the stones by the edge of the cliff, rolling them like dice. I was never able to light the tinderbox. I didn't have something to light it with. Toss a stone over the edge. You flick a stone over the edge of the cliff. It falls in total silence and never seems to land. Is this cliff bottomless, or is there simply soft vegetation below? This isn't going to work. Oh wait, I found something to strike it with? It never worked before. You strike a light from your tinderbox, which flares for a moment. It penetrates barely an arm's length into the darkness, and illuminates nothing of the cliff below. Even if you made a torch, it would not provide enough light to see a way forward. If you wish to see what you are doing, you would do better to wait for dawn. Alright, well, I'm going to rest till daylight. The only thing that stinks is I don't have any rations. Too bad that eagle didn't have any rations for me. Yep. Ah, it stinks. You shiver and pull your cloak about yourself. The hour is late enough already. You will rest here, though there is no shelter, and continue in the light. Laying your pack down by the cliff edge, you try to settle despite the cold. At last you have eaten a... At least you have eaten already today, so do not need to eat again to avoid hunger, though more food will make you stronger. You will need to eat once a day to avoid hunger, but out here food will be hard to come by. That is going to be a little challenging in that regard. You close your eyes and let your tiredness overtake you. The silence is loud in your ears. Slowly, you are understanding the true loneliness of this place. The bustle and clatter of Kare seem a forgotten dream. Sleep. The long night is filled with visions. A hooded woman with a scar down her face looks up from a deck of cards. It would be better if the crown were dropped into the sea, she tells you firmly, or else you should wear it yourself and rule all. A boy sits on a throne of skulls and swords, wearing a crown carved from solid bone. Joffrey? Oh, he's dead. He seems not to notice you, but plays with carved model figurines of goblins, trolls, and demons, playing out a war, though he looks bored by it. And even while you sleep, you know the serpents are moving towards Mampang, and every day you spend out here is a day in which your journey might be discovered. Edge of the Cliff, Day 1. This is cool. During the past day, you gained considerable gold, plus 10, and found 4 new clues. And loud music happened. Morning brings cold, clear light. You wake and find yourself mere inches from the edge of the cliff itself. A good thing you did not roll in the night. Look over the cliff edge. You approach the cliff edge and peer over. The drop is considerable, and the view beyond stretches for miles. But in the daylight, the carved edges you saw last night are revealed to most definitely be an ancient staircase leading down to the ground. In the far distance, birds wheel and turn above the landscape ahead. I'm going to go down the staircase. Casting Featherfall is going to cost us stamina. We don't have food. We have blimberry juice, though. How many blimberry juice do we have? Or do I still have it? 2 doses. Took 1. Okay. They could make this look more obviously like a cliff in the map, I guess. Look at the view. As you stare out across the plains, the featureless dust resolves itself into low, rocky outcrops and gullies. The landscape below is not as featureless as perhaps you first thought. Let me take a drink here and we'll look at the mountains. Beyond the plains, a line of low mountains rises, the Badubak Ridge. A second, higher range is visible beyond, the horns of Ilklala. Their summits must be subject to wild winds, as from here it seems that snow covers them 1 minute, and yet they're a barren rock the next. Look at the plain. The plain. Near at hand you see a spire of rock, rising proud like a stupa? I don't know that word. But through the mist, it seems sometimes that it has 2 prongs and sometimes only 1. Look at the staircase. Look at everything. You turn your attention to the steps down the cliffside. They are carved from the living rock, and their surfaces, perhaps once smooth, are now warped and drilled with holes from the rain, but they lead downwards all the same. How did anyone carve such a slope? What did they stand on to sculpt the stones so high up in the air? The top step is covered with curious bright yellow moss. Sunlight sparkles in the distance. A lake, perhaps? Gather the moss. Intrigued, you grab a fistful of the moss. It is juicy and extremely pungent. Smell the moss. You put your nose deep into the moss. The scent is like lemons and strong cheese and manure all rolled together. It reminds you of the smell of drinking water in Kare. The effect is heady. Fermented moss, maybe? Taste the moss? You taste the moss with a tentative tongue. The flavor is not pleasant, but it does not appear acrid. Perhaps it is not poisonous? I'm going to eat it now because, who knows, it might provide more hit points than we, or more stamina points, rather, than we currently have. I mean, we only need 7. I mean, what if it gives you 5 stamina points? Then I wasted that amount, right? I'm going to stash it in my pack. Oh, no! You stow the moss in your pack, but it quickly dries and crumbles to so much dust. Why? Wait. Sorry, guys. I don't do this very often. I need to see what this thing does, actually. Edge of the cliff. I just could repeat everything. This was strange. I'm like seeing into the past. The figure is me. We didn't lose as... Wait. Did we gain stamina? Did that happen last time? I'm gonna have to watch this video back, guys. We'll go to the cliff edge. We're gonna look at everything. View. Mountains. The plane. The staircase. Gather the moss. Smell the moss. Taste the moss. Let's eat the moss. Okay, cool. So I'm gonna save my blueberry juice then. Feeling bolder, you put the clump of moss into your mouth and chew. Thick yellow juices run down your chin. Swallowing the thick clump is hard, but almost as soon as you do, you feel a great warmth spreading up from your stomach. Whatever this moss is, it seems to be most beneficial. Okay, so I have to remember when I find any more moss, don't put it in your pack. Eat the crap. And hopefully, watch, they'll, you know, they'll turn it up on us and we'll end up chewing a poisonous variety. Gonna climb down the steps. You stride onto the ancient stone staircase, trusting it will not crumble beneath your weight. Then, one pace at a time, you make your way slowly down to the sunken lands below. Halfway down. Yeah, I was kind of cheating, guys, but I don't know. They said food would be scarce, so I'm not going to be rewinding a lot of times. So, I mean, if I can ever help it, I won't do that. But we're doing pretty much okay. We just need rations. You know, stuff we can actually put in our pack without it crumbling to dust. You clamber down the ancient stairs. It is painstaking work, at every step, as every step is about the height of your own body. Then, about halfway to the ground, you are forced to stop. The steps below have fallen to rubble. Look at the remaining stairs. The step on which you stand is in fine condition, perhaps sheltered from the weathering winds by the overhang above. But the next is gone, as are the others after that, stripped from the cliff face, as though scoured. You can make out fragments of fallen rock scattered across the plain below. A few rocks skitter down the steep slope to the ground below. Now, I'm going to cast a spell of Firefall if I can, but what if I make a move? jump? You have no choice but to turn back or else jump. But now I want to cast a spell. Oh look, we've got this stuff over here. Is this supposed to be some weird version of Fog of War, which doesn't really obscure? What happens if I climb back up? I can always rewind. The air stirs a little, still cold, but at least fresh. You make your way down back the heavy stone stairs. Now can we cast a spell? This is different. Somewhere close by, the wind whistles a clear note, as though blowing over the top of a gigantic bottle. You lean from the step to glance around the cliff face and spy a cave mouth in the raw rock of the cliff a little way to the east of where you stand. Perhaps the staircase once led to it, but if so, that ledge is no longer intact. I found a clue. Huh, by going back and forth, I found a clue. Alright, let's see what the clues are... is. The cave of the cliff. At the entrance to the backlands. It's there, and stuff. As the sun climbs toward its zenith, the winds pick up. So I can't cast a spell down there, can I? Why not? Why do I have... I can cast it here. Okay. I'm afraid the Featherfall doesn't last that long. So where's Featherfall? It's not actually... well... it's F-A-L. Maybe lowercase f. Float in the air! You cast a spell, lightening your body weight to a mere fraction of normal. Step off the stairs. You step over to where the staircase ends and beyond. The cave mouth you saw disappears upwards as you drift down to the valley floor. Wait. Is this... hold on. This is more a game mechanics thing. Not an in-world thing. If I cast a spell, can I then make a move and go to the cave? You have no choice but to turn back or else jump. Okay. Guess we're not going to that cave, at least not yet. Whee! Oh, that's a cool animation. Well, not animation, but you know what I'm talking about. It looked neat. You jump and drift gently down to the valley floor. Your weight returns and you settle gradually back down to the ground. The foot of the cliff is punctured by little holes, perhaps the warren of hill foxes, or whatever equivalent, inhabits these barren wastes. You gaze up at the soaring arc of the cliff, barren rock, dusted by what little scrub you can cling onto its sides. But what little scrub can cling onto its sides? It's as if some great clawed hand has scooped out the earth. You can just make out the cave mouth you saw earlier halfway up. It appears quite unreachable. In the near distance, back from the cliff, you can see a stone tower, the only stone structure in the whole barren landscape. The tower. The tower stands some way across the plain, almost in the foothills of the ridge. It lifts to one side, but appears not to have crumbled into ruin. What kind of spell would I cast? Let's move on. This, then, is the plain of Badubak, an endless expanse of dust, broken only by the thin outline of an ancient road. No one from Annaland has been here. No one even knows what happened to this place. Once it was the Archmage's country, his fields and paddocks, but now it is too barren to even be a place of death. cliff. Huh. Well, that is there. Little cave thing. Is this the cave that we were talking about? I want to see if we can... We have to break soon for a decision for you guys to make. Let me just see what's over here, quick. Is this a possible thing? You have reached the bottom of the cliff. Heat beats down from an empty sky. The great cliff rises up into the sky, unclimbable, and looking ready to topple at any moment. You crane your neck to look back at the cliff towering up behind you. Presumably this is why there are no maps of the backlands. Those who fall in never leave. About halfway down you spy the cave you spotted. Totally inaccessible, of course. You take a moment to review your situation. You have no food in your pack, and the plains out here are desolate and largely unoccupied. You'll have to move quickly as possible if you are to avoid starvation. At least you have already eaten today. You turn your eyes to the surrounding wastes. Time to journey outwards into the cursed plains. All other options are gone now. We can only join the old road. I really wanted to find a way up into that cave. You leave the shadow of the cliff for the road that cuts across the plain. The sun is beginning to lower. The air begins to cool. From here, the path is uncertain. Badubak is a wasteland. There is no pass through the great ridge that forms its eastern border. Both of the above. The forest. That's the forest they were talking about. And what else? The tower? Oh no, the Zanzu Peaks and Mampang. I'm not going to make that a choice for you guys, because... Mampang. Where's this Mampang? There is a pretty neat looking bridge, though. I definitely want to check that out. Or is it a building? Yeah, what would a bridge be doing in the middle of a forest? Looks like some kind of building. I do want to check that out, whatever the hell that is. And that's something. And this is something, but we can't go there now. There's a broken bridge across there. So what? The Forest of Snatta is uncharted. Shrug. The Forest of Snatta, to the east of the ridge, is uncharted, and the Kladaback steps are said to be home to only to under-evolved half-humans. Right, the Horns of Ilklala are over here. Right. Is that the tower we saw? Or is that the tower? I mean, can we even see over this ridge? No tracks climb the Horns of Ilklala that lie beyond the forest, and there is no bridge across the great lake beyond that. There may be no road at all. When the Archmage sent his birdmen to steal the crown of kings, they flew. But you must walk. The path beckons. There is no alternative. The future of the old world depends on you finding your way across this lonely dust bowl. Oh my god. Strike out north the blasted tree. It's like too many choices. It's too many choices at this point. Let's check out the blasted tree. Trying to find a way to end the video. You leave the road and walk across the desolate plain. The wind picks up as the evening draws on. It will be night soon, again, already. After a while of walking, you see something to break the monotony. Too tall and thin for a skewer of rock or a building, you cannot place it until you get close. It is a single tree, leafless and dead, tilting from the desolate soil. Look up at the tree. The tree must be the last remnant of an ancient forest, though why this particular trunk has survived when all the others fell is not clear. And that is not all. A rope ladder hangs from one of the higher branches of the tree. I gotta. There might be supplies. You scramble up the rope ladder to get a view across the lands, but the branches seem to be alive, twisting and bending as you climb. They are closing in around you like a trap. Alright, guys, I'm gonna leave it here. What do you think I should do? You think I should climb down? Get out of this trap? Hopefully before they finish closing in around me? Should I untie the ladder? Alright, that would be stupid. I'm on the ladder. Or cut the branches away. I'm aiming for either one or three, not two. But let me know what you guys think. Put your votes in the comments below. And yeah. Thanks very much for watching. Thanks in advance for voting. And endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week.